that's just west of DFW, South Lake Tahoe, Grapevine, Keller area. And before I was elected, I was technically, I was a Tea Party activist. I was involved in a lot of the Tea Parties in my area, on the board, I was on the steering committee. And I saw the sign when I walked in here about the local tax election, the local tax election. So before I became elected, I got involved in two grassroots campaigns, two efforts to oppose tax elections in my district. We won both of those, and we ended up saving the residents of my district. We ended up saving the residents of my district in those tax elections nearly $19,000 a year. So I was very excited to be part of the Tea Party and all those activities. I was also very happy to be part of the legislature, but more importantly, to be with these fellows right here. One of the things you realize very quickly is that only about 20% of what you do down in Austin is voting. The rest of the time you're doing is working together here for the votes. A lot of teamwork comes involved in order to be able to push what we want to get done. And I was thinking about this when I came here about just folks that are here, whether it was, for instance, generally talking about making sure that we didn't have Medicaid expansion in Texas under Obama. It was Van Dale who stood up to appease one, in my opinion, he's the one that stood up when no one was paying attention to stop that driver's permits for immigrants. Sanford, who's the one that from now on will be able to work really closely at the lottery commission to make sure that we're following the rules and that we judge it every year in every session. And Scott Turner, he's a passionate speaker, an incredible speaker, but every time he spoke, a lot of times we talk about his education and how what's been lost in these conversations is what the focus is, and that the focus is education. And then we're talking about background, so I'll stop. I appreciate you being here. Thank you.
I want to follow up on that inappropriate timing of my question, but it's with regard to Cisco and Common Core, which now I understand because people are on to that they're going to change the name. But from what I understood, the state of Texas said no. So I'd like to know from the legislative standpoint, is Common Core C-Scope, which is pushed by Jeb Bush, Microsoft Bill Gates, is it null and void in this state? Because I'm hearing from people in some schools that the teaching of Islam is going on not the teaching of what our history really says, also mathematics, changing what the actual answers are, things that are not based upon facts are being thrown out the window. So I'd like to know, from anyone who knows Common Core, C-Scope, what is the status in Texas? Has it been thrown out, or is it still viable and living? Because I also understand that race to the top gave money to the states, and with those tentacles, put in place Common Core. So can you please tell me what is the status?
Can you answer that please?
Sure. Different standards. There's Common Core, which is really part of Barack Obama's administration to go provide a national standard, if you will, a national curriculum. And then there's C-Scope, and that's related to a curriculum that was developed by regional education service centers in order to reduce costs. Now, Common Core, what we did vote for was to say that we're not going to allow the Common Core curriculum in Texas, and so we won't. But C-Scope, what we said is we want that curriculum before it's used, or any curriculum similar to Cisco, before it's used, has to be approved by your elected officials, primarily and specifically the SBOE. However, after session ends, of course, we do the laws, we know what our intent is, but it seems like at least one SBOE member said, just because the legislature said it has to be reviewed, doesn't mean you can't just download it and share it and use it inside of your schools. And so what we've seen is that there are still schools out there who will probably will continue to use C-Scope. I don't know if you've been, there's a website called Texas Tribune. And if you go to Texas Tribune, I was doing this actually last week. It was, my kids were just about to start school. Monday, a lot of them started. So they have a whole entire C-Scope curriculum online. It's 1,600 lesson plans. And they have a neat little search engine. So I'm like, all right, what don't I want to be in there? So I typed in abortion, and I typed in search. Sure enough, part of the curriculum includes a discussion on counseling, pre- and post-abortion counseling. I went and I did look up Mecca, and they have a map, and they said, and you know, some of it makes sense, okay, on this map, draw where the Chinese wall is, draw where the Statue of Liberty is, draw a trek to Mecca. And so he said, why would we put that there? Why would we have some of this stuff inside of it? So what we're trying to do, or what we tried to do, is kill it dead. And part of what happened is it was a nonprofit effectively that was created to go and develop this. And then it had an intellectual property agreement with the schools. The schools would license it and pay back for that. And what we said is, hey, listen, you're gonna review that and do all that, but it went out in the public domain, i.e. the internet, and there's schools that are gonna keep using it. There's schools, in fact, there was a school, Lano ISD, where some individuals had tried to sue to stop C-SCO from being used, and that lawsuit was thrown out of court. There's a really good debate between Dan Patrick, who's running for lieutenant governor, and also with Thomas Ratliff, the SBOE member, where they go back and forth. This was on last Friday or last Saturday. Yeah, Saturday. And it was a pretty good back and forth. So when it shows up on YouTube, you'll learn a lot about what C-SCO is and what it shouldn't be.